Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Excel Charts Chapter 8, creating a chart for every customer. Well, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. This podcast is going to be a little bit longer than usual, but it's a cool, cool trick. We want to create a chart for every single customer in this database. We're going to do that using a pivot table. So insert pivot table, click OK. Let's see, I want to create a chart showing revenue, definitely, by product. And I want to see that for every single customer. So I'm going to take the customer field up into the report filter. Now you'll see why later we're going to do that. Let's do a little bit of formatting here to get the pivot table to look good. Grand totals, we're going to turn those off. Report layout, we're going to go back to tabular form. That gets rid of the word row labels and replaces it with the word product. Here for revenue, we're going to do space revenue instead of sum of revenue. I think that just sounds better. Notice you can't type revenue, you have to type space revenue. It has to be different than the other fields in the table. And then here, I want to format these revenue amounts. Actually, you know what? Let's show them as percentages. So we'll come here to one of the revenue amounts and options. Under calculations, we'll say show values as a percentage of the column total. So now we can see everyone's percentage of the total. All right, so now we have this. Using the filter, we could very slowly go through and show each customer one at a time. But that's not what we're going to do. I'm going to undo that. I'm going to show you a great trick here. We're going to go to the Pivot Table Tools Options. On the left-hand side, there's a button called Options. I don't want you to choose that button. I want you to choose the drop-down next to the button, something called Show Report Filter Pages. All right. And because I have Customer up in the Report Filter field, it offers it here in this dialog. Now watch this Sheet 2 when I click OK. Watch what happens. All right. Did you see that? They just inserted several new worksheets, one for every customer. So we can scroll through here. So for every customer in the database, they created a brand new worksheet. Now, it'd be really great if Show Report Filter Pages worked with pivot charts, but unfortunately it doesn't. So what we have to do is now add a pivot chart for each of these items. And here's how I'm going to do that. I'm going to choose the first item and then shift click on the last item. So I've chosen all of those items and I want to make sure to choose a single cell on each of those sheets. Now that I've done that, I can right click and choose ungroup sheets. All right, and then we want to create our chart. Now if I just press Alt F1, I'm going to get, it looks like a column chart is the default chart on this particular computer. Let's change that. Design, change chart type. We'll go with a pie chart. Click OK. Maybe customize things a little bit more. We'll get rid of the legend. Off. Data labels. More data label options. We'll show category name and percentage. Click close. All right. So now that chart is pretty close to what I want. I actually don't even want the field button, so we'll turn those off. Hide all. And there we go. Okay, now that I have this chart, watch this next step. We're going to go into Save as Template, and we'll just call it Chapter 8. Good. Change chart type. Go find that template. So let's see right there. Chapter 8. You can hover to see the name, so Chapter 8, and then Set as Default Chart. All right, so now I've created my own custom chart type. I've set that as the default, and now it's easy. I just go to each sheet and press Alt F1. Next sheet, Alt F1. Next sheet, Alt F1. To go to the next sheet, it's Control Page Down. So I'm just going to go through and create these charts one at a time using Alt F1. The trick there, though, is we set up a template and taught Excel what our favorite chart type would be. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.